If you've mastered didomy, tithemy, to put or place, should be no major problem. Tithemy and didomy follow the basic same principles. That is, you have a simple stem, which the simple stem is always going to be found in your aorist. In the present, it's reduplicated. So when you see that reduplicated stem, tithe, right, the theta is not going to be tithe, but tithe, it's going to shift to the unaspirated tau. The reduplicated stem in the present, and imperfect, and the simple stem in the aorist, and the rest of the stems are perfectly normal. They're going to conjugate like a normal verb. Now, the other thing that it follows like didomy is that in the present, actives, singulars, or in the singular actives, you're going to have a long stem, and in the plurals, you're going to use the short stem. So let's take a look at these. In the active, we've got the present here on top, and I know it's present. We're using the present stem because we've got the reduplication, and we have our normal endings added right onto the stem. So tithemi, tithes, tithesi, and it's singular, so long, right? Eta is long, and in the plural, short. Tithemen, tithete, titheasin. So long, tithemi, tithes, tithesi. Plural short, tithemen, tithete, titheasin. Same thing in the imperfect, which is also formed again off of the present stem. Et tithein, long, et tithes, et tithe. And in the plural short, et tithemen, et tithete, et tithesan. So, in the active voice, singulars long, active voice, plurals short, both of them are going to use that reduplicated stem. In the middle, we're going to keep the short stem entirely. So, etithemi, etithesi, etithetai, or rather, tithemi, tithesi, tithetai, right onto the stem of tithe. Tithemetha, tithestha, tithentai. That's our present. And in our imperfect, still going to use the short stem. We're going to add our augment, and that should be an epsilon there, because the stem is tithe. Et tithemain, et titheso, et titheto. Et tithemetha, et tithestha, et tithento. Remember, these are athematic. We don't add the omicron before the endings. Therefore, we don't need to contract the intervocalic sigma. We just add the endings right onto that stem of tithe. The imperative, same thing. All right, we've got tithe, and this is really adding our ending of epsilon, and then you contract that. So tithe, titheto, tithete, tithenton. And in the, so that's the active, present active. And here below, the present middle and passives. Take our short stem, titheso, tithestho, tithestha, tithesthon, adding our endings right onto the stem of tithe, that present stem. Infinitives and participles, same thing. Remember, me verbs have this different infinitive ending, so tithenai, tithesthai, and then we're going to add our, again, each me verb is going to have a slightly different participle. Tithes, tithesa, tithen, but then it becomes a first and third, just like you would with all other present active participles. Tithentos, tithesis, and tithentos. And in the middle and passive, tithemenos, so we've got our stem, our men, and our ending. Same thing for all genders. In all cases, all numbers. Stem, men, os. Stem, men, ooh, and so on. So remember, these are the present infinitives and participles. And I know they're present, to reiterate, because there's the reduplicated stem. Now in the aorist, we're going to use the simple stem. And we have that same rule, present, long. or a singular long. Etheka, ethikos, etheka. Also notice the kappa, just like in didomi. And then plural short, ethemen, ethete, ethesam. And in the middle, we're going to use the short stem, ethemen, ethu, etheto. And here, yes, there is a contraction going on. It just happened with didomi too. Ethemethe, etheste, ethenton. Ethento. So, other than that second person singular, pay attention to it. It follows some very strict rules. Imperatives, same, we've got our simple stem, the short version, the. We add our name, so thes, theto, thete, thenton. And in the middle, these are the actives up here. Middle, thu, theso, theste, theston. Remember, imperatives have no augment, so keep those out of there. Infinitives and participles, also no augment, and same rule. So thenai, thestai, thesathen, with the entos being our stem, themenos, stem, men, os, for our middle participles. And you'll notice in all of these, we have the simple stem, just the the stem. Is that all you need to know for tithemi? Yes. For tithemi, tithemi only acts irregularly in the present tenses, that is the present imperfect, and the aorist tenses. Perfectly normal thematic verb in the future, perfectly normal thematic verb in the perfect tenses, and the aorist and future passives act like you have already learned. So pay attention to the aorist, the present, and the imperfect, and you'll be fine.